In this video, I'm going to show you how to add optical snoot effects in Photoshop to make your plain and boring backdrops pop. So I'm also going to show you how to add colors to these effects. Okay, let's do this. So the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to go on top here on select. I'm just going to left click on it, and then I'm going to select subject here. Or you can use other selection tools from here. You can select subject or quick selection. You can use one of these tools here, but the quickest one is just to go on select here and then you click on select subject. Photoshop is going to select the subject for you. Let me just select the move tool. So what I'm going to do from here on my keyboard, I'm just going to press Ctrl plus C on Windows or Command plus C on a Mac to copy my selection here. And then I'm going to press Ctrl plus V on Windows or Command plus V on a Mac like this to paste my selection. So I have a new layer here. So what I'm going to do from here, I'm going to go to my Snoot effects. So I'm going to put the link in the video description to where you can download these Snoot effects. And then you have to import it in your Photoshop. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to copy one of these effects here. Let's start with this one here. So I'm going to go to my tools here, and then I'm going to select the rectangular marquee tool here. I'm going to select this, just going to left click, drag it like this, and then I'm going to press Ctrl plus C on Windows or Command plus C on a Mac to copy my selection like this. And then I'm going to go back to this image. On my layers here, I'm going to select the background layer here, the layer below the first layer. And then I'm going to press Ctrl plus V on Windows or Command plus V on a Mac to paste my selection like this. So my selection is behind here. I'm going to go back to my layers here. On this layer, I'm going to right click and then I'm going to select Convert to Smart Object here. So what I'm going to do from here, I'm just going to hold Ctrl on Windows or Command on a Mac, and then I'm going to press T on the keyboard. And then I'm going to free transform this. I'm going to expand it like this. I'll leave it maybe somewhere here like this, and then maybe I'll move it up here. Maybe I can take it down like this. It depends with how big I want this effect to be. Let me just take it to maybe somewhere here. If I want, I can just click on this icon, or I can just press enter on the keyboard like this. So from here, I'm going to go to blend modes here. I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to select screen here. So we have our snoot effect here. So this is the before, this is the after. But I want my effect to look as realistic as possible. So I'm going to go up here on filter, and then I'm going to select blur, and then I'm going to select Gaussian blur. So this box is going to pop up. Let me just put it here. So I'm going to reduce the Gaussian blur to 0.1, and then I'll start moving it up to maybe 30%, and then I'm just going to click OK here. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. The reason why I converted this layer into a smart object, if I feel like my effect here is too much, like the blur is too much, I can just double click on the Gaussian blur here, and then I can maybe reduce it to maybe 19%. Or if I want more of this effect, I can just take it to maybe 40%. Or 45%. That's the reason why I converted this layer into a smart object. I can go back to this layer and make adjustments to this layer. So maybe this is too much. Let me just take it to maybe 36%, and then I'm going to click OK. So if I want, I can just go on opacity here and then reduce the opacity to maybe 65%. This is the before, this is the after. So now let me show you how to add colors to these effects. So let's move to this image here. I'm going to go on top here. I'm going to go on select, and then I'm going to select subject here. Photoshop is going to select the subject for me. Let me just zoom in a little bit like this. So what I want to add this part to my selection. So I'm going to go on my tools here, and then I'm going to select the quick selection here. I'm going to go up here, and then I'm going to select this icon with a plus on top. I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller using the brackets on the keyboard. Then I'm going to add this part to my selection. Even this part, like that. I'm going to select the minus, and then I'll just remove this from my selection, like that. If you want, you can use the pen tool to make the selection. So once you have your selection like this, let me just zoom out. So Ctrl plus 0 on Windows or Command plus 0 on a Mac to zoom out like this. So let me just select this, and then I remove this part. So what I'm going to do from here, I'm just going to press Ctrl plus C on Windows or Command plus C on a Mac to copy my selection. And then I'm going to Alt Ctrl plus V on Windows or Command plus V on Mac to paste my selection like this. So from here, I'm going to go to my effects here. I'm going to go to my tools here, and then I'm going to select the rectangular marquee tool here. I'm going to select this one here. And then I'm going to press Ctrl plus C on Windows or Command plus C on a Mac to make a copy of this selection. I'm going to go back to my image on layers here. I'm going to select the background layer here. And then I'm going to press Ctrl plus V or Command plus V to paste my effect like this. So I'm going to right click on the Snoot effect layer here. And then I'm going to select Convert to Smart Object here. So I'm going to hold Ctrl on Windows or Command on a Mac. And then I'm going to press T on the keyboard. So from here, I'm going to expand the Snoot effect like this. I'm just going to click on this icon here. So now I'm going to go to blend modes here, and then I'm going to select screen here. So what I can do from here to just spice up this effect, I can just go to filter here and then blur and then Gaussian blur here. The radius of 30 is okay. And then I'm going to click OK here. So now let me show you how you can add colors to this Snoot effect. So I'm going to go down on this circle here. I'm just going to left click on it, and then I'm going to select Use Saturation here. So I'm going to clip this adjustment to this layer here, so that whatever adjustments I'm going to make to this, they are just going to be applied to this layer. So I'm just going to click on the clipping mask here. I'm just going to left click on it. So from here, I'm just going to click on colorize here like this. I'm going to go on U here. I can just move this slider to go through the colors like this. But what I want more of these colors. So I'm going to go on saturation here. I'm going to take it all the way to 100%. And then I'm going to move this icon here like this. So this is how you can add colors to the Snoot effects here. Let me just take it to maybe here. Let me just put it here. Let me just close it here. So this is the before, this is the after. So what I can do from here to make this photo stand out more, I can just maybe select the layer on top here like this. And then I'm going to go to my actions here. And then I'm going to go to my retouching actions pack. And then I'm going to select light contrast here like this. Let me just close this. Let me just zoom in a little bit like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. The light contrast and these other actions from here, they are in my retouching actions pack. I'll put the links in the video description below to where you can download my retouching actions pack. So before you do everything that I've shown you in these examples, the first thing that you need to do is to retouch your image. So if you want to learn how to retouch your photos in less than 10 minutes, you should check this video here.